you hear me?
I can't hear myself.
Interesting. Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody.
There is still some friends.
Can you hear me? Maybe
now it's better.
Can you hear me? So,
hello and welcome. I can't hear myself. What is this thing? I can't hear myself. Why?
Oh, okay. Now I'm... Nice. Okay, now it's a bit better. Welcome, everyone. Today it's a bit of a different session from the usual one. I'm going to, as I wrote in the title of the video, I'm going to do a tabletop concert using only acoustic instruments and a vinyl player, and a lot of effects and just, you know, this kind of things. So we have a lot of different stuff. We have like... this is the hugest one. And it's a Glockenspiel. Really huge Glockenspiel. Then we have a couple of different... things. Percussion. Hey, yeah. We are going to play a little bit with all this. There is also a bell here. So yeah, basically today we are going to make something with all this stuff and try to create a completely different, sonic situation from my usual electronic setup. Today I'm gonna play just with acoustic sounds and live electronics. I hope you can enjoy it and you will like it. I know there are a couple of huge streams today, but yeah, I don't care. Quarantine sessions are daily streams, I remember you. And so basically we are going to start very quietly, just with our vinyl player and a lot of effects. So I'm gonna play an album that is, I think that YouTube will shut down my stream if I play it just as it is, but I'm going to process it live, so it will be you know, unrecognizable. This album is called Japan Exorcising Ghosts, and it's a really interesting album from 1984. The people involved in this album are David Sylvian, Steve Jensen, Richard Barbieri, Mick Karn. There is also Ryuichi Sakamoto in some of the tracks. So it's a super cool album from the 80s. Experimental pop music. And yeah, I'm gonna play it for you, but, you know, in a really weird way.
Thank you.
So. Not too many people connected today. Well, there is still a lot of reverb somewhere. Okay, now I think it's better. So, that was a long improvisation. Yeah. So that was it. It was a really interesting experiment. As you may know, I'm really happy to improvise and change something in my way of making music. And this is a really good example. It was super fun to try to reimagine all the sounds in a completely new soundscape, just to explore not only the sound in itself, but also the performing, the action, the physical action that you do. For example, you know, throwing these things on the glockenspiel and see what random sound it creates. This is not only something about sound, it's also something about performance and how you conceive a piece, a track. This is a good example for me of the way that I use when I'm approaching to a new performance or a new composition. I'm trying to discover which kind of actions can be really connected with the sound result, and can be also really, which can summon things. For example, a very interesting object that I used today is this one, which is a metronome, physical metronome, and this is pretty, it summons something, it summons feelings, because, it's not only a metronome, it's also a sound source, rhythmical sound source, and at the same time, it's a symbol. It's a symbol of the time that is moving on and it's going on. And this is really powerful for me. It means a lot to have such kind of instrument in an improvisation, because it gives sense to the improvisation. It gives a new meaning to the improvisation. Or, for example, throwing this one on the glockenspiel, it's another action that has some sense, some meaning, and gives meaning to the improvisation. For example, using a trumpet just with your breath gives it a new, completely new meaning. Basically, this is a really interesting experiment to do. For example, I really love the sound of these shells, seashells. They are great, but also they have a meaning in their self, because, they remind me of the summers, of the past summers, or the summers when I was a child, and I was used to collect them on the beach when I went on vacation with my parents. And also, maybe it's a really common experience to collect the shells on the beach, not only for children, but also for adult people, or even, in your experience, you may have experienced this thing. So this is sound which is connected to a meaning, and at the same time, it's sound connected to a performance, because I'm not just using them, I'm just putting my hands and, you know, searching for something. And this is super cool, in my opinion. It's something that gives really a sense to what you're doing. And this is just an example. I really like the part where I use the, for example, the vinyl cover as an instrument. So the sound of the paper. And also I use it to play the glockenspiel. It was not just an accident of, you know, I need to change the vinyl on the vinyl player. I used this thing as an actual instrument. So yeah, this is kind of, I think, a good overview on my approach on composition and performance and improvisation art. I think it's a really good example. And yeah, maybe I can just move the camera so you can see me while I'm talking. Let me check. Well, I think I'm in the frame right now. So yeah, basically this is super cool for me. This is a really, really important thing. Maybe I can use also this one. Yeah, maybe I can use this one also. So it's a really interesting experiment. Just using acoustic sounds, of course, some live electronics, but as you saw, I didn't use the live electronics in an active way. I just set it up on my, you know, my usual setup and just connected these microphones, which are three microphones. There is one up there on the bell, on the tubular bell, one here for this one, and one here for everything, also this one for everything. So yeah, basically, I didn't use live electronics in an active way. I just use it as passive processing, which is okay, because I wanted to focus more on the acoustic part of the performance and on the actions, on the gestures of the performance. So yeah, basically, as I said, this kind of performance shows exactly what is my process. My process in improvisation and composition involves actions and sound and meaning, and all these three elements are deeply connected with each other in my performances. Maybe in the electronic music field, it's something that is not so clear, because, you know, there are the interfaces and there are the electronic instruments, which has this... they are not really connected with the sound. The action and the gestures that you make are not really connected with the sound result of it. It's really much more evident when you use acoustic instruments. So the connection between your action and the sound, it's clear for the listener, for the viewer. But basically, for me, as a performer, as a composer, this is the process. This is the process. I think it was such a great experience that I need to stop here. Yeah, because it was I need to think about it. I'm thinking in this moment, and then when I'm speaking to you, I need to think a little bit about it and try to understand what this kind of this way of composing means to me. It was a super nice experience. It was a long time that I didn't play in this way, with a lot of objects and stuff. So it was a really deep experience for me. really deep experience, and I need now to take a break and to think about it. And I'm happy that you are here with me. I hope you enjoyed this this improvisation. It was an interesting journey, and it was a pleasure to share it with you. Thank you, and see you tomorrow with another quarantine session. Have a nice time. Take care of yourself, and bye.